Science and the social study teacher. So today I'm going to study the social study for grade 5. First of all, I'm going to introduce our lesson by our objective. So our lesson, it is lesson 2, the Romance, from page 134 to page 137. Our objectives: first of all, identify some of the Julius Caesar's accomplishment, and then identify the famous places of the Roman Empire, and the last one, describe the life during the time of the Roman Empire. First of all, we're going to speak about the Roman, identify the Roman first. So the Europe, the Europe are started being inactive and importing in the world by the beginning of the Roman Empire. And then the first emperor of the Roman Empire is called the Julius Caesar Augustus Emperor. So after that, we're going to speak about the Julius Caesar accomplishment. The first of all, he developed a network of roads. He founded a courier system that allowed the delivering mails to people living far away. The third thing, he was able to build a strong army in that time. He was able to build a strong army, the firefighting station, and the system of taxes, and then he gave people to the freedom and the believing in whatever religion they choose. After that, the different famous places in the Roman Empire were. So first one we're going to see here for the first picture, it is the Roman theater. The permanent famous theater was the theater of the Pompeii, as we're going to see here. It's surrounded by seas and very large place here, and then it's the arena where the gladiator used to get in contact with other gladiators and wild animals, or even the criminals in that time. This it is the arenas, and this one is the Roman theater. After that, the different characteristic of the Roman. The Roman used a language, and that time was the official language used in the Roman Empire is called the Latin. The Latin, and then the Latin became the origin of the Italian and the French and Spanish languages. And after that, the life in the Roman Empire revolved around the city of Rome and the seven hills surrounding it. After that, the Roman contribution to the architecture. The architecture, the first one, this going to see the picture here is the picture of domes. After that, it is the arches. After that, we go to then the some characteristic of the Roman period. The first one, the Roman were able to conquer so many countries because they had such a good and strong army at that time. The Roman army was very, very well organized. Also, the Roman army was used for the protection of the Rome and controlled the people in area which had been conquered. And the last one, the slavery existed widely, and many slaves market we found in the city. And the last one, the slaves was bought and sold by the aristocrat. And then the aristocrat, now here are we going to speak here. The aristocrat were the people of high social status, and usually they were the rich people who had the right to members of the government. At that time, this the rich man, I'm going to see here, this is their own suits or clothes are famous in that time, are very rich men. After that, the Roman Empire, they makes a lot of wars and combats between each other. The empire was felled after the invasion of the Germanic troops and many other barbarians. So, thank you so much for attention, and see you next lesson.